Richie Anitpuna Show. With me, Heather Barton. Richie.
Their signs say, "Fear God." On a fleet of motorhomes, they carry the message of what will happen May 21st, 2011.
There's going to be a worldwide earthquake, and what's going to happen is the graves are going to open, the dead in Christ are going to rise first.
They're part of a nationwide movement that's put a date on Judgment Day, as calculated by radio and internet preacher Harold Camping.
Then the whole universe is going to be destroyed by fire.
Okay, well, the 89-year-old wacky minister, Harold Camping, predicted that the world would end last week.
And he said that everybody left would be in hell, so we're in hell right now.
We've been in hell. But he said a cataclysmic earthquake would strike New Zealand at about 6 p.m. our time, and then all these people were going to go to heaven. We were going to see them floating up to heaven. And we were all going to be left here.
Why
do
you say we were all going to be
left? Well, you know you are, and I kind of figured I was. But we'd be left here to October 21st and be overrun by zombies. So I looked up.
October 21st, that's my niece Caitlin's birthday. How come that?
I don't think it has anything to do with Caitlin. She's a good girl. She would have went to heaven. But I looked up how to kill zombies, and just to let everybody know, if it does happen, you have to chop their head off. You can't shoot.
Heather's a zombie killer.
So I figure, like, over the next couple weeks, if I happen to chop somebody's head off, it's just because I thought they were a zombie, not because I didn't
anything
like
else?
Them. No. But get your swords and machetes ready just in case, because that's how you have to chop their head off one swipe and move on from that.
But I can't use a chainsaw.
Yeah, but that's heavy, and then you'd have to, like, lift it. No. But a bunch of those people, this is what I'm wondering right now. All those people that followed this guy, they quit their jobs, they sold their houses and their belongings, I guess gave him the money.
Put their pets down.
And I also read that a woman tried to kill her kid somewhere because she was afraid to leave. I guess she thought he was going to be suffering here. Like, was he a bad kid? But what are they doing today? Where are these people? I want to hear from them. Where are they?
Because so call in now, 1-800, you're an asshole.
They woke up and they basically are like homeless now, jobless. Yeah. Now they just all have to kill themselves, right?
And that number again is 1-800, you're an asshole.
Right. But I feel sorry for them in a way.
I don't feel sorry.
Do you need to be needed
them.
That badly to follow a cult that says that? But there was people profiting off of this because there was people putting things on Craigslist saying, we'll take care of your animals, because they were saying the animals weren't going to go. But I thought animals go to heaven too, because that movie, All Dogs Go to Heaven.
Oh, boy.
And they said people were going to take care of their animals for like $50 or something like that, and said, well,
that's what they were saying is 50.
That's what I said.
See, under the fucking word, I'd be like 10,000.
Right, because it's bad enough I'm going to have to fend for food. Now I'm going to have to fend for an animal.
I go through that on a daily basis.
I know, poor thing.
Well, May 19th, we went downtown to Sherry Honkala's campaign headquarters to kick off my announcement running for city commissioner, and right, you know, her bid for candidacy for sheriff of Philadelphia.
Right, and to get signatures.
Get signatures for the ballot, and about 75, 80 people were there to support everybody. It was a great time. I mean, people were all geared up and ready to go.
Drinking,
wondering what they can do
partying,
for me.
Eating.
We were taking pictures.
Cheese
Carla was there filming.
Right.
You were bobbing for, what was you bobbing for? You're bobbing for something. What was he bobbing for back there?
Keep it up. Well, I just wanted to mention that it was a great group of people.
It was.
But I had at one point to get out of that building because so many people in there, I can't even tell you how many people had bad breath in there. And we're talking right in my face.
They must not have watched our show when you talked about
it. I swear, because it's they get this close.
You should have walked around handing out Tic Tacs.
Next time, I swear to God, I'm getting some kind of breath mint, and I'm offering it, because they're just so unconscious of it. If you know you're going to be speaking in a group of people in a small
Heather will not be invited to any more events anymore.
I love the events there. It was great. But the bad breath thing is really getting to me. People need to just stop and just take a
minute. Smell the bacon.
Brush your teeth. They have these little things, the Listerine.
Yeah, the thing is just stick on your tongue, too.
There you go. Plenty of.
It's like what do you call that at church when you put that thing on your tongue? What's that called?
I don't know.
It's almost like a
communion. I can't deal with that. I can't. But anyway, back on May 6th, our Communities Connect OCC held a summit at CWEP's offices at 2801 Frankfort Avenue. Along with their partners, Area Health Frankfort Campus, Best Behavioral Healthcare Incorporated, Cade Kids Community Women's Education Project, and the Providence Center. They secured a $240,000 grant from the city's Department of Behavioral Health to improve services for agencies and organizations who provide recovery and social services to residents in the 24th and 25th district.
Which covers what?
The 24th and 25th.
Which covers what?
The fuck are you trying to say?
Want to cover Kensington? Damn, you don't even fucking know.
Well, yeah, I know it's Kensington.
Well, that's why I was asking you. Kensington.
Stay out of my business. Last year, according to the figures from the city's Office of Addiction Services, the 24th and 25th, which
covers what?
They said those areas are the most stricken by drug addiction and violence. So they accounted for the highest ratio of shootings in any neighborhoods in the city and the highest rate of death with drugs and arrests for drug sales, more than 3.5 times higher than the citywide average. Instead of helping residents navigate the services of City Hall, OCC hopes to help residents of the 24th and 25th who need health services, drug addiction counseling, behavioral health services, and many other forms of care to find the help they need by connecting providers in a way they haven't done before. So,
what way?
Well, like it just said, you had to go through the city to get the services, and they're trying to start with their own organization.
In the community?
Yeah, and then other organizations join them, and now they have the money for, to help fund that.
Cool.
They'll be able to do it. So for more information, if you're interested, you can go to ourcommunitiesconnect.com.
Last month, in Fort East
not
Falls.
In, right, well, just not in.
That's
just
what
don't
it says.
Put the in
well,
in.
That's what it says. Last month, four East Falls teachers at Thomas Mifflin Elementary School filed lawsuits against a black principal and the Philadelphia School District. They say the principal called them unfit to teach the African-American students. According to the original report from the courthouse news service, the teachers say they were routinely sabotaged, just like Heather does to me with these fucking things right here. In relationships with their students, while the principal let black teachers overlook, override, or flat out ignore school rules and policies. He did his best to make sure black teachers controlled the union. That's what they claim. Schedules were changed without notice, access to school supplies were denied, room assignments were randomly switched, and poor professional performance marks were issued for teachers simply because of their race. They also claimed that they were forced to read an article which argued white teachers were unable to teach black students. But the principal let black teachers flat out ignore the school rules and policies and also made sure that black teachers controlled the union and weeded out white representatives in a scheme that ignored union voting procedure. When the teachers complained, they became the targets of an investigation which was intimidate, harass, and find basis for firing, according to their suits. They said their personal information, including home addresses, were disclosed to a hired investigator, causing them to fear for their own family's safety. The teachers are seeking $150,000 in damages, alleging civil rights statutes. Depending on how this case ends, it could change civil rights laws.
That's a first. I can't even believe it's the other way around, usually. But what? I can't see, how can they say that color or race has anything to do with the ability to teach a kid? It's weird.
I don't know. That's a whole nother, like, oh, go see Oprah. Go see Oprah.
Oh, Oprah called, too. We're taking over her new show. Really? We're taking off the time slot. Yeah, channel 6.
We got the slot.
Stay tuned next month.
4 o'clock every day.
Imagine that. They'd never let us on it. Okay, well, although this is not Philly, I had to tell this story because in Middletown Township, Bucks County, cops stopped an ice cream truck for a DUI and found water bottles filled with piss and one in the freezer where they kept the treats.
I'm sure they'll find that in every truck in this city.
Well, that was my point. Police say 46-year-old Yasser Hassan was visibly drunk when he was pulled over. When police searched the Trenton, New Jersey man's truck, they found boxes of wine along with bottles of urine. The lieutenant told the press that a passing motorist called police after seeing the ice cream truck driving erratically. Hassan faces a June 1st hearing on misdemeanor drunk driving charges. Now, I don't know why anybody's so shocked about that, because where do they go to the bathroom?
Exactly.
They're not going to leave it on the side of the road and jump out.
And even if they do, they don't wash their hands.
Yeah.
And then they're holding their cone.
You're taking a risk no matter where you eat.
Yeah, that's why I don't order from them.
Well, I think you got to be careful which ones, because some of them you can tell are cleaner
all of them.
Inside. But if they're going to piss in something, they should have it off to the side somewhere.
Shouldn't be on
no
the truck.
Food. Or maybe in the front or something.
Well, Heather put a correction in here for me.
I didn't put a correction.
Oh, you didn't? Who did?
Northeast Times.
Oh, well, this doesn't say that.
Yeah.
Story referred to the wrong priest. In a Northeast Times story, the Reverend Robert Brennan, named in a lawsuit filed a few weeks ago by a man who claims that he had been sexually abused by the priest as a youngster, was incorrectly identified. That fucking sucks. As a clergyman with the same last name who had been arrested earlier this year on child molestation charges. That priest is Reverend James Brennan. Same name, right? His case has not gone to trial.
So they both were up for charges, but they just named the wrong one in the wrong case.
Wrong case, but they both molested just the wrong kid.
They got the wrong case with both names, but so they're both jerk-offs
right. And
pedophiles.
Yeah.
So, just goes to show you. In the Northeast Times, there was also a story about the 100 Club, which I think you might be a member. It's a club made up of people who have made it to 100 years old or older. Every year, the mayor rents a hall and hires a band and caterer for the group. At a party held in South Philly, about 20 Northeast residents were among 100 Philadelphians honored during the city's centenarians.
Centenarians. Are you being bullied?
Celebration Day at the Sheet Metal Workers Union Hall on Columbus Boulevard. The oldest man, Lazar Asman, was born in Russia 105 years ago. City officials weren't sure if the decorated veteran of two wars made it to the party on Friday. Although the event was well organized, not everybody sat at their assigned tables, so it was hard to say at times who was there.
They're over a fucking 100 years old. They probably couldn't read their seat assignment.
The oldest woman was 111 years old, Anna Henderson from West Philadelphia, and is the city's oldest resident. She's about 3 years shy of the world record.
Wow.
That's amazing. City officials say there are more than 400 Philadelphians who have lived more than a century. What are they eating?
They must not be eating at McDonald's and shit. That's
yeah.
What they ain't eating.
I want to know.
I went down to the Trenton Avenue Arts Festival two weeks ago, and it was the largest one yet. There had to be like 4,000 people, probably even more. I mean, it was just jam-packed, great time. All the vendors, they had the kinetic race where everybody just made stuff that had to be pedaled, and they rode it through like a mud pit. And
yeah, like costumes and stuff.
Well, yeah, you had to dress up, but I mean, they had big ass floats and stuff. Like they drove through with like six bikes connected, but Steve Hack was a judge there. You know, the guy that takes the photograph.
Yeah.
Him and Lisa. And I saw a lot of people. It was a good time. They had live band, live music. It was a great time.
Cool.
They had phones ringing.
Phones ringing.
All right, now for a time for Kenzo moments. Hugh Zelensky wrote, I was 14 years old, strolling down Kensington Avenue on a Saturday morning about 11, smoking a joint, minding my own business, and the police detectives busted me. ruined my high. Another time, there were some crazy holy rollers down on the Ave trying to recruit for their cult. They had easels with pics of scriptures and from the Bible, and so me, who had went to Ascension, started telling them what they meant. The holy rollers were impressed. They wanted me to join. I said, no thanks. A couple of nights later, again, strolling along the Ave, smoking J's and drinking a beer, blasting the boombox, I hear my name being yelled out. I turned around and it's these friggin' holy rollers, about 10 of them, running down the Ave toward me. I take off and they are chasing me. I got away, but again, it ruined my high.
Oh, that's a shame.
That's a shame.
That had to be 80s.
It was the 80s.
Yeah. Well, Chef Devlin says, I see all the corners and names in Kenzo Land, but the realest spot was Jasper Street, CWB. All you know, on a Friday night, you would leave your hangout and come to Conwell, where the best, rest in peace, Bip and John John, and the rest, rest in peace, WW. Oh, I guess he meant we miss you. He put WWE.
He did, or you did?
I didn't write it. He wrote it.
Oh, so you copy and pasted it?
That I did. It's their words. Jenny Nery said, I hung in Conwell in 1977 till the 80s. I was from the youngest crowd, I would say. The older crowd was Leroy the Carpenters. So many names. Great place to hang. We were regulars, meaning every day of the week. Kristen Danzit said, I remember when Rocky V was being filmed and the scene where Tommy Gunn flew up Rose Hill in the Mustang was done real late at night because we kept yelling and making noise and messing up the scene.
Chuck Fuller wrote, if you give a Japanese man a fish, he will eat for a day. If you give a Japanese man a fishing net, he might find some of his kids. Well, that's fucked up. He's good for them quotes, though. I like it when he puts it
around. All right. Well, in the Philadelphia Weekly, people write into a guy, Dan Savage, not the guy that was office. It's his own column, for advice on personal issues. And I wanted to share a few from the Savage Love section.
All right. Well, here's one of them. It's question. I'm a young, hetero, flexible guy who has been a sugar baby for a handful of wealthy older guys. I love it. I get money. I have fun being with them. And the guys seem to like having me around. The problem is that I just got with a new guy who is really great, except for one thing. He's HIV positive. That's always a problem. Yeah. He says that his doctors predict he won't have a shortened lifespan and may not even have any symptoms that would make his life uncomfortable. I like the fact that he told me, and I am open to being with him sexually. He's very submissive. He wants to be used and abused sexually, physically, and mentally.
Wow.
That sounds like a guy for you. My question is, what kind of sex acts are okay to do with this guy? I read on one site that him rimming me is fine, but I can't find a site specifically that explains which sex acts are safe and which ones aren't when one person is positive and one person is negative.
Do you have an answer for him?
I wouldn't know. How the fuck would I know?
You don't know about rimming?
You're a lesbian, ain't you?
Do you know about rimming?
No.
No, not yet, but I'm almost.
I don't know nothing about rimming. I thought he was changing a tire or something. I don't know what the fuck that means.
Rimming. I'll explain it to you later. Well, another question posted was, I suppose you are going to call me an asshole. Is this from you?
Yes.
Once you have finished reading my letter, but I hope you have some advice for me regardless. I am a 45-year-old heterosexual male. My last relationship lasted nearly 7 years. I am discouraged. One of the reasons for my discouragement, I have to get too far into a relationship before I can determine if it will work out in any particular woman. An awful lot of emotion, time, and efforts are required to get that first look into a woman's panties. And this is where my problem lies. A woman can have the sweetest personality, she can be pretty and hardworking, but if her cha-cha isn't bald and her little man in the boat doesn't fit comfortably in my mouth, I am not turned on. I require a shaved and big clit.
What's a clit? Is that the little man
in the boat? You never seen a clit before? Look down in your pants. That's a clit. Yours is just big.
I got
you. He would want you. You have a big clit, and you just shaved today.
I did. Look at that.
See that? I have heard women say that they were disappointed to find that a man's blank was too small or too large, or they didn't like that it curved to the left or the right.
See, mine curves down. Doesn't like a hook.
Should be up. You're deformed.
I am.
So he says, do I have the right to a similar preference? What do I do? Is there a way to ask about these issues before emotion, time, and effort are invested? He says, call me an asshole. Well, you could check and see if they have like a really big camel toe. That'll give you a clue.
Hmm.
You know? And stretchy pants are back in style, so you can check that stuff. So that's my advice to you, Dan. Or no,
I don't think he was fucking asking you.
Well, I think you can tell if a woman has a really big camel toe with a knuckle and then
Moose knuckle.
Yeah. That's how you tell.
And horse nipples.
Yeah.
Well, now it's Family Fun Day, right? Mm-hmm. Well, there's a musical tribute to Frank Sinatra playing at the Walnut Theater. My Way, it's called. It's running till July 3rd. Tickets are $30. Also at the Walnut, Click Clack Moo, Saturday, June 4th. Showings are 10:30, 1 o'clock, and 3:30. It's a hilarious, moving, and utterly fabulous musical about friendship and sharing. So I guess that has something to do with cows. Tickets are $10 or $14. For more information, you can call them at 215-574-3550 or go to www.walnutstreettheater.org.
Well, it's Philly Beer Week, June 3rd to the 12th, which kicks off at the Independence Visitor Center at 6th and Market. There are a ton of places to go for unique and tasty beers. Maudite Midnight Madness kicks off on Friday the 3rd at Devil's Den in South Philly. Free samples from Long Island's Blue Point Brewing Company from 4 to 6. Memphis Tap Room in Kensington, Port Richmond is pouring they don't even know which one it is. Is it Kensington or Port Richmond?
It's Port Fishington.
Is pouring non-stop new and unique beers with no repeats all week. It starts at 11:30 a.m.
Well, Bridget Foy's on South Street. You can get some good beer and dinner for $35 from 4 to 10. O'Neill's Pub on South Street will have giveaways from 5 to 7. Six Point Crafts Ales of Brooklyn, New York, takes over Silk City, where you can spend a day in the beer garden sampling drafts and snacks. Head inside in the evening for beer-inspired dinner specials and finish in the lounge dancing to DJ. This party will run all day and night. Perch Pub in Center City is doing the best of the 70s, and many more bars are participating. Check out the website. I don't know what it is, but check it out.
It'll be at the
okay.
end. Philly on Tap walking tour from City Hall. Walk through the streets in pursuit of Philly's favorite local beers inside the city's best places to drink. Get a first hand. I did it again.
First hand.
Why can't I say that word?
Are your teeth in right? Let me see.
You know these are mine. Get a first-hand glimpse of three of our city's pubs, bars, and lounges while enjoying a local beer at each location and a snack or two. And at the Rittenhouse Square, one drink at each bar is included with the tour, as well as a quick stop for one of the most popular snacks in the city. Perfect with your beer. I don't know what the popular snack is. Maybe a pretzel. Right.
Snap to a Slim Jim.
Advance ticket purchase required for $30, and it's from 5 to 7. For more info on any of these events, you can go to phillybeerweek.org.
And for the kiddies, The Flea and the Professor at the Arden Theater at 2nd Street and Filbert. Shows run every day except Monday, so it don't run every day.
Right. Every day except Monday.
Well, and it doesn't run every day.
Except Monday.
Call 215-922-1122.
Or you can take the kids out to learn about the city on a trolley, big bus, or carriage ride. Tours leave from 5th and Market. Your 24-hour or 48-hour pass will give you the freedom of unlimited on and off privileges between any of the 21 stops throughout the city. They run 9:30 to 5 weekdays till 6 on weekends. You can call 389-TOUR or go to phillytour.com.
That sounds cool.
It is. Well, that's all we have for you today. Hope to see you again next week. Take care.
Bye,
live,
everybody.
Live, love, laugh.
Live, love, laugh. Live, love, laugh.